In his acceptance speech overnight, President-elect Donald said America needs to come together and, quote, bind the wounds of division. He also promised to be the president for all people. On 60 Minutes Sunday, CBS News contributor and Republican strategist Frank Luntz gathered a focus group of undecided voters. It revealed how deep those divisions are.
How did we get to the point where every one of you, with different backgrounds, different politics, different objectives, all of you gave me a negative reaction? How did we get here?
Because we need positive
one at a time.
Talk about.
No more talking over each other.
Out the election. That's how.
He was not cheated.
He was cheated. He was cheated.
How did we get here?
It's our fault. You saw it here. Everybody's arguing. I'm afraid to even bring up a point. I'm not pro-Trump, but I see why people like him. And, you know, if I say that, I'm going to be, you know, ostracized.
Frank Luntz joins us at the table. There was so much negativity with the group last night, in that group that you showed us on 60 Minutes. And last night, Donald Trump has promised to unite us when so many people believe he's the one that helped divide this country. How is he able to prove, or how is he able to prove to people that I'm the one who can turn things around? How was he able to do that?
Well, first, last night's speech was the best speech I've seen Donald Trump give. It truly was magnanimous. He was reaching out. He said the kinds of commitments that I was hoping he would say, and he appeared to be serious. And
did
even
you
his,
doubt it, Frank?
And even his, well, I doubt everything about politics right now. Let's start with the exit polls, because I'm a pollster.
Yeah.
Virtually every state was wrong. That they predicted either the wrong winner or they were off by 4 or 5, and Ohio was almost 10% it was off. Why? Because Donald Trump voters don't even want to participate in polls. They don't want to tell pollsters what they're doing, not because they're afraid, but because they're uncooperative. They're so hostile to the system that they feel like that is giving in.
Well, Donald Trump's campaign paid millions of dollars to an overseas firm. It is called Cambridge Analytica. $5 million in September alone. They used data points from gym memberships, from transactions on loyalty cards, charity donations, all to target their voters. And the data people that work for Cambridge Analytica say they knew over 10 days ago that they might win this election. So are the pollsters wrong, and there's another new way to gather data out there that the political class hasn't picked up on yet?
You have to be able to read people when they don't necessarily tell you who they're going to vote for, that there are other things as part of the decision-making process.
But the Obama team did that in 2008, 2012. They said, we can tell by what kind of car you buy. We can tell by what channel you watch. Yeah, micro-targeting.
But the issue now is when you are so upset with the way things are going, when you think Washington has betrayed you and Wall Street has betrayed you, then you absolutely, you're not going to cooperate, and you're going to find some other way to express your point of view. Now, I went to a couple of Trump rallies on Monday, and what I saw were people who not only couldn't wait to vote, but they were going to drag 10, 15 people with them.
Where was that?
The level of intensity in Pennsylvania, which he won, and in North Carolina, which he won. Hillary Clinton, we forget that Hillary Clinton was actually not a good candidate. In a traditional election, being First Lady, Secretary of State, and Senator would absolutely qualify you and would probably propel you to the presidency. But if you have an American electorate that is so angry with the system and so angry with the elites as part of the system, that's actually negative.
Did we hear that she was not a good candidate before last night?
Absolutely.
It seems like I'm hearing that more and more last night. Until then, everyone, you know, she was Hillary Clinton, the most qualified candidate, the best suited for the job, the best temperament. Now we're hearing not a good candidate.
Being a great candidate.
And also, she had a 43-42% favorability rating before. 53-54% didn't like her. We forgot that. We weren't talking about the fact that she had the highest negativity of any Democratic nominee. And now we are being reminded of it. And one more. We did a survey last night, 1,200 voters, and we asked them if it was Bernie Sanders versus Donald Trump, who would win. By 8 points, they preferred Bernie Sanders over Donald Trump. And the reason why? Character. Mm-hmm. We want to say that elections are about policy. They aren't. They're actually about who do you trust, who do you have more faith in, and who do you think understands you.
So you think this election was more about character or change? Mm-hmm.
I think it was more about change, and it's not just change in terms of policy, mm-hmm. it's in terms of trust. And they simply didn't trust her. And the exit polls, which I don't want to cite ever again, But even the exit polls talked about the lack of trust in Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, but they also said that change was the most important driving factor.
Right, and that's why I don't understand why they were so wrong, why they had Clinton winning in state after state that Trump actually won. This is a very interesting, I think it's actually a very good day for democracy, and it's a very bad day for pollsters.
Mm-hmm. Do you consider yourself a pollster?
Of course not.
Okay.
I did yesterday, but today yes. I'm now a communication specialist.
Okay, got it. Got it, Frank.
Always reinvent yourself.
Yeah, yeah, and I have to do it every week, so I've become good at it.
Communication specialist, got it.
All right, thank you.